choking seas. Raise a glass in celebration, broken trees. Make a toast to amputation, our glory burns. Shine a light, mesmerized by information, learned minds, valued thoughtful decimation. They feel they're doing right, they think the future's bright. When did the fires of hell start to look like heaven?
Glorify codes and signs, formulas they enshrine, reading the land, rise of mayhem. Worshipping spells of harm, reading the progress chime.
Celebrate death to the living. All the children free. How can you not care? Why will you not live for peace?
Ooh. The tide is turning, the levee's straining, but you're so proud, the wall keeps forming. Your disconnection is not perfection, all your inventions are aberrations. Persisting, the excavation of the lambing's fortune. Your brutal niceness, your kind indifference, perpetuates the endless destruction.
You see, all lies wear thin. What we're seeing through, what I've been seeing through these years of pulling out, so I'm in the system, brainwashed. I used to bring up to $4,000 a week income for most of 20 years. I didn't do it all the time. And I wasn't a great businessman. I was on an ego trip. And I was on a power control. I used to manipulate people around me, not intentionally to hurt them, but to manipulate because I wanted to protect my financial commercial interests. Because it was mine. It's part of mind. Mind. It's mind. Do you mind writing that down? Because I wouldn't mind covering that again. Mind, individual, person, etc. We'll talk about this as well, this deception. But you'll find that in scrutinizing and starting to realize what sense, and then good people coming into our lives along the way as we're fighting the court case over the stealing of the family home that was Fiona's, we started to realize the bigger picture. And here we are now since 2006, where I'm out of the system. I no longer have contracts anymore. I don't have Medicare. I don't have birth certificates and driver's license. I don't use them anymore. They still exist out there. I don't rent them anymore. Again, it's explained in the name is the Mark of the Beast video. And it touched on under the spell of intellectual property, and it's covered in the video interview with Ben Lowry. We go into more of that. But the point is, every generation has man that wakes up. Now, this is something else to be aware of. And you'll have noticed this. If you use your brain and scrutinize, since the 1950s, particularly the 1960s, up to present sense now, this is what we call time now, any man that has an influence over public thinking, any man with a conscience who speaks truth or speaks of what they know to be truth, have died. Either died of cancer, have been assassinated, have unfortunate accidents, etc. But you find there's literally no one anywhere anymore. Anywhere. Because they had to get rid of them all. Because as they push through this new agenda, the new system, they don't want any resistance. You also notice that the middle class in the system, they had to reduce their power using financial might and money power by coming together using might to fight against their systems. So they're destroying the money belt of the middle class everywhere. And you see this through Agenda 21. And you'll see it under globalism. And you'll see it under the banks and the interest rates and how we've lost over 500,000 farming families since the 1960s here, just on the land we call the Commonwealth of Australia. Even though it's all part of the system, and all the farmers all trapped in the system. You're seeing the devastation of all this. You're also seeing people who came and went like Pauline Hanson, who rose up as the One Nation Party. Really, that was a white ant project. It was a Freemasonic satanic scam. I'm just going to give you a touch on some of these things, because this goes on every area of your lives and why some of us have to wake up and rise up above all this madness. Pauline Hanson was set up as the fish and chips lady, the wonderful little fish and chips lady, came out of nowhere to become the hero of the rednecks of Queensland. Most of the rednecks of Queensland, were victims or had relationships to victims who were farmers who had their land stolen from them from bank interest rates that went right through the roof, and they couldn't afford to service their debts. Now, anyone who does their homework on bank interest rates will tell you the deception of how money is created out of thin air, and interest is just man-made. It's not determined by the economy. It's by people who press buttons and tell you what that interest rate's going to be. You'll see all that. But what we now have is the force behind the banking system enforcing through law, the system law of the high priesthoods, of the Freemasons, and the politicians who represent the high priests and all that, moving in on those farmers, particularly those farmers who resisted, had some resistance, so they would send in 16, 20, 30 or 40 police in there and sheriffs to boot them out and take over the land, allow the banks to then sell that land off. And what remains of those lands, vast majority, are now in private interest, controlled by large private corporations who produce all the food that we now get through Woolworths and Coles and Aldi and elsewhere. They're controlling the food supply. They're controlling all aspects. Now, people are going to wake up and realize there's the common denominator. Who are these people? How is this all orchestrated? So when Pauline Hanson comes along, she's targeting the redneck because she's speaking the mantras of the One Nation. And everyone starts to join One Nation, thinking here's a voice for all of them to make right what's been made wrong. And then inside the One Nation, the Freemasonic satanic lodges, the right wing side of it, where you've got Tony Abbott and all the other David Ettridge and all these other guys were caught up in it. And I'm naming you guys, you're part of this problem, you're in on it. You set up One Nation to fall from within. They destroyed it from within and from without and blow it all in your faces to tell everybody who got caught up with Pauline Hanson movement that you haven't got the ability to get together, you haven't got a voice to make right what's been made wrong, you haven't got power. And you've been all dispersed and broken down into individuals. You're still those ants under the system. So now each of you are easy pickings, right? That's one tactic. Another tactic is a judge that came out a few years ago, Justice Ironfeld. Hello to you. We know you watch these videos, as many of you watch these videos. We know that you're all scared to death, not of us, because you're trapped by the same problem and you want out, you want sanctuary. We know that because we've had some of your visitors here. I've been talking to some of you. I won't mention your names. I'm not going to destroy who your family is. But we know who you are. But here's the thing, he comes out not paying any statute fines, right? It gets caught up in the media because people find out he's not paying for parking fines or whatever those statute fines are. And this gets dragged down into a total controversy. The whole drama is played out in current affairs till eventually they get federal police or whoever they were who breaks into his Wallara home in Sydney, whatever it was, 2-3 in the morning. And this is all played out in mainstream media. And the people watching all this are going, oh my God, if they can do it to him, they could do it to my mother. They could do it to my father. They could do it to my uncle and auntie, my grandfather. They could do it to my next door neighbor. They could do it to my mates. They could do it to Jack and Jill up the hill. They can do it to me. We're not safe. You see, this is a precedence of whitewashing, white-anting. He was in on it. They work as both the good guys and the bad guys. It's all coordinated chaos. And everyone who can't see it get deceived into this. Another one, we have this guy called Fitzgibbon, a barrister. He got caught up with a guy called Ian Henke over a common law issue to do with the Australian Taxation Office being formed illegally. It wasn't constitutional. And there's a lot more to this. It's not just this, I'm just touching on it. To me, a lot of the people caught up in this, including Wayne Levick, are in on it. They're Masons. This whole matter was taken to the High Court. They couldn't do anything. They took it to England, took it out into the common law courts in England under the Lords, etc. Eventually, no power. So they took it to the higher courts of the United Nations at The Hague, where they got knocked on the head as well. And they set up a white ant, a whitewashing trail, where anyone else who came along and wanted to use that wouldn't bother using it because they tried it and didn't work. When in fact, if they did use it and they knew what they were doing, they would get somewhere. But really what happens, they come up against force. Because in the end, anyone who wakes up from the UCC that people think is today, from the common law, from admiralty law, anyone who comes across any of this stuff of the law, it's not going to give you freedom. Because if you wake up above the fog of this mist, when you wake up above all the brainwashing that are the blinds that have shut you behind the curtains of sense, because the sense is the light that you blocked off because you're now in the darkness of that images, that is the hood. This, as I told you about the kale, the sisterhood, the brotherhood, the priesthood. You're under the hood of the intellectual property. You're now under Alice in Wonderland, representing Alice in Wonderland. You're under the universe. You're under the history. You're brainwashed, right? They don't want you to break that spell. But if you break up, you wake up, you break out of that spell, and you stick your head up above astrology and theology and wake up above all the bullshit that you're on a journey heading from somewhere to somewhere, and we're all tiny aspects of the universe that the effects of greater forces than us. When you wake up, the pieces of paper have no power. Who is your master? Who are you providing paper to self-cure your problem? Is it another man? Are not all men equal? Who are you asking for your power? So those who really wake up, who stick up their head above the fog of all this darkness, they see force, and force sees you.
An experience force
who passed down the tactics of my brain control and tactics of assassination and chaos, and they target you. Most of the cancer is engineered by man. Most of the sickness that we know today is engineered by man, if not all of it. I suspect all of it, because it's not natural. It's all nonsense. And we'll explain about sickness and disease shortly, about the breath. It all goes back to the breath of life. It's all engineered by man. In the records of the history, who can bring forth the Dark Ages in present sense and tell us that the Dark Ages, what was written in their books was true? Do you know anyone who can come forward and tell us, yes, I was there? There's nobody can come forward to tell us that they were there. No one anywhere. People want to say that they found ancient scripts of information from the Christos going back 100,000 years. Where is 100,000 years to tell us about? 100,000 years. Please come forward and tell us. Is it true that the Christos existed of your time? Hello, Christos, where are you? Hello, Dark Ages, where are you? Hello, ancient times, where are you? Can anyone come forward in present sense where our children can go and have a direct experience with it without us having to explain it to them? No, they can't. It's impossible. It needs a man brainwashed into falling into those images to represent that Alice in Wonderland, his story. His story. It's a storyteller of the Christos, the storyteller of the Dark Ages, the storyteller of the plagues. Remember, you're diving through read and write alphabet languages. You're diving through the history of the satanic world, guys. You're not diving through sense. When you go through sense, there's not another man between you and nature, because you have it in the water. Fiona's breath, everything she's thinking and feeling and doing, is set into motion in the water. I can access the water, that is the breath, to sense everything that she's thinking and feeling. When you and I are communicating through telephone and mobile phones and through video cameras, we are sensing each other as well through the water in present sense. We don't need to use copper and radio waves and microwaves and dead corpse technology we call video cameras and all that to communicate. We actually can shift our bodies through the water, through sense. We can talk to each other through sense, which is the song of nature. It's the sound of nature, not of talk, this alphabet talk. This is unnatural. It's nonsense. It's brainwashing language. But we know that we can use the dead to reach the dead, to bring them back to the living. We can use fiction to reach those lost to fiction, to pull them back to nonfiction, to pull them back to sense. So when we communicate through these videos, we use sense to communicate with your sense. So you can sense us. Because even after you stop watching this video, even while you're watching this video, the sense of this man is present to you. The Christ that is this man is present to you, the Christ. The breath that is your breath is present to this man in present sense here and now. There is nowhere where your breath has not been and never will be that is not present to me. Because your breath is present throughout the whole of the dream of life. It is not confined to time and space. As is the original breath of the Creator. As is the original breath of every man that ever was and ever will be. As is the original breath of every creature that breathes and breathes in and breathes out. Everything is of the breath, is of water. We'll go into this a bit more later. So when you look at this nonsense and you dive into this nonsense and you rise up your head above the fog of all this nonsense, you see force, and force sees you. So the spell is being broken. The spell has no longer got you. So they've got to try and find a way to defeat you, because they do not want you to dispel the darkness that is the fog in the brains of everybody else trapped in Wonderland's story, his story. They don't want you in Wonderland. So what we're doing is reaching everybody that's been exposed to Santos Bonacci's rubbish about astrotheology. Everyone exposed to astrology. Everyone exposed to numerology. Everybody exposed to Ramtha and the channeling of Matthew and Creon and all this garbage. Everyone exposed to time codes set to the Mayan calendar. Everyone exposed to every sacred scroll and script everywhere. It's all garbage, guys. It's all rubbish. We are creating it. Man. We are man. Our brothers are man. Our descendants to come are man. We're all present with the presence of life, sitting into motion in present sense, the fraud of nonsense. You cannot bring forward the Mayan calendar and communicate with it through sense. The Mayan calendar does not exist, just as Alice doesn't exist. All you can go to is to Bill and Mary, representing the characters. You can touch and taste Bill and Mary. You can touch and taste the representative of the Mayan calendar that is a man. You can touch and taste the man who's representing the police officer, or the man who's representing politician, or the man representing common law, or constitution, or democracy, or the man coming forward representing the UCC, or the private foundations, or any of the supposed remedies and cures of all these things, which is all garbage too, guys. Watch out for Peter Duff and his foundation. It's rubbish. Watch out for people like Mark McMurtry. He's a liar. He's trapping all you original people. We're telling you straight out. There's Mark Pytelic is another one. Mark is caught up in this. I'm saying it to Mark. I've already told Mark to his face, as I've already pointed this to Mark McMurtry. These people are compromised. Thomas Anderson is another one. They all represent intellectual property. They've got to keep you in the system because they don't offer you a remedy. WikiLeaks, with the nutcase behind WikiLeaks, he's one of them, the good guys. You're going to find the good guys coming out everywhere, like Lord Monckton behind the global warming. You got now what her name is, Anne Bassington, coming out now. Maybe she's innocent. Maybe she doesn't know the big picture yet. But they're all trap guys. They do not offer you the remedy that gets you out of the system. They keep you, they reveal you the truth about all the lies, but they don't give you the remedy out. Because what's happening, the good guys are coming forward now to give you the next system remedy of oneness. And the oneness glue, the ant colony glue, right? Where you're going to give up all responsibility for your life in these new super cities, where you're going to have free public transport. All debts and all mortgages will all be wiped out. You will no longer have to carry credit cards. Nothing. It's all free. This is exactly the Star Trek Federation image, guys. You're going to be living in the world of Star Trek now. The images have been brainwashed into for so long, you're going to accept the Federation that are the high priests behind it of the New World Order. That is the system. But you won't have to take any responsibility for your life because they'll provide you with everything. This is why we created this food forest, and we'll bring up the video of the food forest. Why? We man, our power comes from taking full responsibility for everything we think, feel, and do in present sense. For the food, for the forest, for the water, for the land, for the children. We take complete responsibility without another man interceding, another third party, telling us how to think, feel, and act. If we do it through sense, we don't need the system because we're conscious. It's only in a state of nonsense when we're representing Judaism, Christianity, and the system of commerce, and all the dumbed-down stupidity of all this historic information that comes out of university, where we think it's impossible, and we think of words like utopia, which really means at an arm's length. It's utopia, guys. It's impossible. We can't do it. And if someone brings up the truth about some of these, oh, it's a conspiracy theory, guys, when really it's organized crime. We're exposing organized crime if you look at it carefully. This is what we do. We're not into conspiracy theory or peddling it because we can back it. You can explain this. So the system is about you giving up responsibility. So you're under limited liability, limited responsibility, because now Fiona is no longer responsible about the information that's coming supposedly from the Kale. She's now under my standing. She understands what I've told her. I have higher power than her. If she does that, she's given me an outlet to now manipulate and control her, because she'll trust me, so she'll learn to accept other suggestions that I'll give to her, hypnotic suggestions. I'll start giving her other spells. Hey, Fiona, do you know there's a thing called the Galactic Federation? And this is higher beings? And they're going to come and rescue you from the suffering you currently have. And you can become this new ager, and you can go out there and rejoice and dance.
And so we don't have to worry about anything anymore.
You don't have to worry about anything. It's all been taken care of. You don't have to take responsibility. Or, Fee, you're now a Christian. I've worked hard on you. Jesus is going to come to save you, see?
So I don't have to worry about anything.
No. And everything you've done wrong throughout all your life, and everyone else you've been part of, will all be made right when you go back to heaven. This God sitting on this high, on this power throne, is going to forgive you for all the destruction, to all the things that you've caused chaos. He's not going to worry about you bringing all these problems with you to heaven. He's going to see, oh, well, it doesn't matter. They're my children. I won't care that they're going to run amok amongst heaven and destroy everything here as well. Isn't that absurd, guys? Do you think that the Creator sitting on a throne, allowing all his children, destroying everything he created, would come back to his heaven and haven't learned to take responsibility? How are they suddenly going to miraculously, out of nowhere, is he just going to wipe their brains clean? Now they're suddenly enlightened and they're totally of the Creator? Where's their free will? Where's their responsibility? Where's their true power? If that was the case, they are now sheep. They're marionettes. They're puppets under the strings of belief of this supposed supreme power. This is absurdity, guys. Don't you think that the Creator of this dream is no different to a mother and a father who love their children, who wish them to do greater than them, and don't set any boundaries to them, and wish them to do greater than they ever could do? Don't you think that the Creator of this dream of life wishes man to do greater than even the Creator, and everything the Creator created, without doing harm?
And expect them to look after the gift of life that's been given.
Exactly. The idea that it is an almighty supreme power sitting on a throne overlooking man on earth is a Freemasonic satanic image of nonsense, because no child can go and visit anywhere across earth right now in present sense. Immediately right now, let's go and visit the Creator in present sense on the throne. You can't, because it's an apparition. And we'll talk about apparitions a bit later. I must not forget about this, because we want to cover this in this video as well. But what you've got here are the images of a supreme power, an almighty power, looking over a heavenly hierarchy of archangels to cherubs and everything in between. And because the dumbed-down Christians that I've brainwashed you into under that spell now that you call the Bible, because you're now a Christian, or you're newborn Christian, see? I've got you under the spell now, and because you've accepted all these other images of this incredible hierarchy, you'll accept the same image of the hierarchy that rules you here and now. So in the meantime, while you say, I don't have to worry about my responsibility because Jesus is coming to save me, and I'm going to the afterlife because I'm saved. I've given up responsibility. Or the Galactic Federation, or any other magic wand coming from the good guys as an economic remedy through Nasara, or whatever. You'll see the same thread of this nonsense through all recorded history, going back through all read and write alphabet languages, no matter how far back you go through the tongue, they are all of the system. All the holy books, all the alphabet languages, all the occults and esoterics are of the system of that time. If there was no system, they would not exist either. It's not needed. We already got everything, guys. Everything and more. It's in the water. It's in present sense. We have it all here and now. But you've got to access it through sense, which means don't interfere with our children. Don't fill up our children's heads with nonsense. Don't put them into the schools, which we have to learn to pull our kids out of. Don't introduce them to all the bullshit that they're learning. Let them have a direct experience with the water, with the breath of man, because they get access to the true library of man, to the true purpose of the Creator, because it's in present sense. That is the living song, not the rubbish of the living word as the Bible. Where's the living word? John and Mary knock on our door and they say, we've got the living word of God with us. Have you? Bring forth this God to back your claim. Hello, God. Where are you? Please come forward. Is it true what John and Mary are saying here? Hello, God. God.
Hello, Moses. Hello, Jesus.
Hello, any character in the Bible. Please come forward and back this claim in present sense so we can sense, touch, taste, feel, smell, hear, see. Why is your God invisible? Where are they? You see, they haven't got the living word, because if it was the living word, we'd be getting a direct experience of the Creator as a living, direct first party. Why do we have a representative representing this God? Why do we have scientists representing science? Why do we have engineers representing engineers? Why do we have experts representing expert knowledge? Why do we have teachers representing what teachers teach? Why do we have politicians representing politics? Why do we have people of law representing law? Why can't we have a direct experience without having to go through another man all men are created equal. No man is master of another man. The original man was created in an original form. We all have direct experience to the original man and to the original breath and to everything is original, because original means uniqueness. But you take that uniqueness, originality away when you brainwash that man into someone else's image, which is what this grand architect did, this nutcase, this man. He came up with this image. Now we have sameness, what we call oneness, oneness, universe, one story. So all engineers believe in the same system science story. They all believe in the same history of the telescope and the microscope. They all believe in the same history of astrology, astronomy, etc. It is nonsense. There is no such thing as oneness. We are unique, not one the same as the next. Not one grain of sand is the same as the next. No original DNA is in the image of another form of DNA. It's always been like that and always will be like that. We'll talk about the original breath and how we add to the original breath in a minute. See, these are spells. We're all under the spells of intellectual property. They're images that don't have any sense. We've removed sense out of them. Well, in fact, they were never given sense. Those images were set into motion in the water without sense. And so we have to represent all these occults and esoterics, which is what alphabet languages and mathematics are of. They're all fantasy, illusion and delusion. And while we are lost in nonsense under that spell, we'll disconnect from each other. We're now the ant colony. And worst of all, we are that sun, because now it's I, my astrology, my faith, my belief, my Jesus, you know, my Bible, it's mine, my breath. Well, I can't breathe out now because I own it. Because when it's mine, you own it. Imagine if you own your last breath, drink or meal, and you don't let it go, guys. You die. Well, that's what they taught you to do under the spell of intellectual property. They taught you to believe, have faith, and have associated opinion with nonsense images. So you're lost in nonsense. Nonsense is darkness, anti-life. It has no life. There's no life being set into motion. It's the dead world.
It's the absence of life.
It's the absence of life. Yeah. See, so we're doing the best we can to get this message across to everybody, to realize, stop falling for nonsense. Because if you keep falling for nonsense, you'll keep falling for storytellers. The whole change towards the New World Order is currently being made up of men and women spinning spells. And they cover all the areas of this now consciousness, we call consciousness and oneness and the universe and quantum physics and our relationship to all these things that are moving all around us, right? And they're preparing you to give you another system. But you've got to have the foundations of the philosophies and the belief systems so you'll accept the kind of cashless Star Trek kind of Federation way of life that you'll enter into. And so you're going to get the good guys now coming out, pointing out the crimes behind Agenda 21 and the lies behind Christianity and the lies behind all the other occults and esoteric, because they got to destroy it all, because their ancestors were all party to this. But to prepare the sheeple, the dumbed down, lost to nonsense, to enter the next version of the system where they maintain their slave status again, they have to be seen as heroes and good guys and being of moral correct fibre. But if you look carefully at these people, they're all false, because none of them are offering you a remedy out of the system.
And if they were coming out as out-and-out bad guys, we'd all stand up and rebel against them. So we have to be lulled into thinking, oh, look at them, they've got the answer. It's their our new Jesus, our new Galactic Federation, our new whatever, because they are going to give us the way out of this mess that we've all created.
Yeah. If there was an overt dictatorship, we'd eventually, Sheeple inside the prisons, would eventually want to rebel, because we're going to see for what it really is. Eventually someone's going to wake up and go, well, you don't want that. They know that because they've experienced this, the breaking out, the mass exodus has occurred before and many times before. So now they've done it through covert means, through brainwashing under these spells that I've been telling you about. I'm telling you. And they're casting a whole lot of spells now. This is why you've got the Dalai Lama, the Deepak Chopra, and 1,001 other New Age books floating around all over the place, filling your heads up with all this oneness stuff and all this kind of information through Matthew channeling and Ramtha channeling and on it goes. It's just saturation point.
And this is why we're always saying you can spend years, you can spend the rest of your life, as it were, delving into all this stuff, investigating it all, researching it all, documenting it all. But all the time you're doing all that and learning and learning and learning, you're still in the system and you're still supporting the system.
Yeah, exactly. And you're a slave and you're lost in nonsense. And that's what we're here to do, to stop this from happening, to return to kindoms without the G, K-I-N-D-O-M. I don't mean dumb as in dumb. The good intention of kindom, meaning the tribes, we're bonds of families and tribes of man.
Because all that information can never lead us to anything that's of the truth of out of the system, because it is all of the system. So you can't get back to sense and to truth using the information of the system. All we can do, we've got to go back to where the truth of life is, which is nature and everything living, to get the sense.
This is what we did in the work we've been doing since 2006, or started 2005, but the real serious work 2006 onwards. We realized we had to go back before man fell into nonsense to find the remedy. But we didn't know what that meant. We just were sensing it. So as we kept working through and realizing and learning what sense was and learning what nonsense was, we had to go right back before alphabet languages, before recorded scripts and scrolls and tablets and everything, because this is all Masonic, Freemasonic, satanic rubbish. We had to go back to sense. We had to go back before we fell into nonsense, before we fell into unconsciousness, before we fell into darkness, to get the remedy. We had to go back to where man was, who man really is, to get the answer. This is what we're saying. You don't have to represent truth. I don't have to teach Fiona truth, so she represents my truth as if it's her truth. The moment we try to represent truth is now a lie, because that truth is now my truth. It's my story, my history. We only have to direct our children to truth by going direct experience to man, to nature, without us having to indoctrinate by explaining to them what we observe and what we're experiencing. We can share the experience, but we don't force them under that experience. We don't put them under the spell of that image, which is what we do. So another thing about this, and I get a lot of phone calls about this from people at the moment. I got a phone call today from a guy from Germany, and he's asking about the UCC. And you know the commercial codes of the UCC, and I'm saying, well, it's pieces of paper. Who is your master? Who is behind UCC? Who is the power that you're asking for to cure your state of ownership? Because why would you go to a piece of paper or go to a history that's UCC or common law or admiralty law or any law, statute or not, be it commerce or not, gold standard or not, be it insurance or not, be it limited or not in that way? Why would you want to use any of that to go and get yourself freedom? How can you go to something that doesn't provide freedom to give you freedom? How can you go to something that isn't truth to give you truth? How can you go to something that is dead to give you life? So who are you answerable to? What pieces of paper? Now, I explain this. For you to have a system means that you believe you own something. It means you're coveting something, in this case a piece of land. If you're claiming ownership over land, which you can't back, you can't prove it, there's no authority to say you own it. But if you want to protect it, you're now going to need a system in place to protect that claim you have, as well as everybody else who's got that claim. Now we're back in the system again. Great. You see, we're not supposed to own anything. We've already got everything. But they taught us to own. They taught us to believe. They taught us to have faith. They taught us to have opinions that we call Christianity, Judaism, astrology, theology, etc. Everything that is in the system. And all the images that make up the hierarchies of the judges and the rule of law and the high courts and the federal magistrates' courts and the Supreme Court and the local courts and all this stuff. It's all nonsense, guys. It's all garbage. You see, there's no one to go to. Because there's no higher power than man. There's no higher power than you. We're all equal. All we've got to do is do no harm. Through feelings, thoughts, words, deeds, actions, etc. That's all we've got to do.
One of the big problems, I think, in particularly the Western world societies, is that we mistake choice for freedom. So because we've got all these choices, everyone goes, oh, aren't we lucky to live in Australia? It's a free country. But it's not free. We have choice in that I can be whatever religion I want. I can wear the clothes I want. I can drive the car I want. I can live in whatever place I want. I can choose the job I want. Well, if I'm lucky, I can choose the job I want. But that's not freedom. I'm still within the system. I'm still having to work day in, day out just to get food on the table and a roof over the head. I'm not free. I'm not free to get up and contemplate and take care of my responsibilities but still have time to enjoy life and experience the joy of life. All I have is choice, not freedom.
You are compliant to the statutes and all the laws while you're thinking that you're free in the system. You haven't got freedom. You still pay your bills. The bills come in the mail because you've got a contract with that bill that you call electricity. You gave up responsibility, full responsibility for life. Life is the natural electricity. You gave up responsibility for water. So now you have the water board and all the private corporations tunneling through copper pipes, whatever garbage, plastic they use, into the water. Then we have the local councils who have taken responsibility because you gave up responsibility for your poo and wheeze that you would normally go and put into your food forest and where you would place it. Now we desecrate the water of our ancestors, of all their breath, because that's what water is, and we call it toilets and we pee in it and poo in it and do all that stuff. We're desecrating everything and we're so compromised.
On a larger scale, the pollution that we're putting into the water, the chemicals, the rubbish, everything, we're constantly desecrating the water.
Yeah, exactly. You see, we're supposed to be taking full responsibility in direct experience of the water that is around where we're walking and standing. Full responsibility for the food forests. That includes the plains and valleys and the hills and the mountains and the oceans and all that. Not the oceans, but the shorelines and stuff that we now call beaches and things. We now, under the system, we have these false dogmas. We run around thinking people are free, that we got rights and that the system gives us rights. But while you have the system, while you're running around as a journalist and you think you've got rights, while you're running around being a lawyer, whatever you think you are, and you've got rights, you have slaves and rulers out there who are busting their asses for you to have what you want are the good bits of the system. But are you going to take responsibility for all the harm that's been caused to every man, woman and child that you have to access and use to provide you with the shirts, to provide you with the services, to provide you with the clothing, to provide you with the transport, to provide you with whatever's been manufactured in third world countries, in places where children have been prostituted in labour for up to 16 hours a day? Are you going to take responsibility for every man, woman and child has to be brainwashed to become the cogs in the wheels of the system of progress, who have to give up their originality, all their uniqueness, so that you can have the good bits of the system that you're running around claiming, that gives you some kind of privilege and exclusivity, sitting on some house that's worth $1 million, having children go to the best schools, while a vast population can't even do that in the system, even though the whole thing is insane. The whole thing is absurd. You see,
and the fact that we accept this total privilege and exclusivity, especially, well, if you live in a more privileged area of the world, that's what you do. You excuse it somehow, or worst of all, we try and put it aside. We don't want to research sweatshops and this, that and the other, because the truth comes back to the fact that we're the reason they exist. With all child labor,
we're setting into motion slavery. While we live that lie, we set everybody else into motion of that lie as well. While we live that falseness, everyone else around us lives that falseness. Everybody's trapped. While you are trapped living the lie, everyone else around you is also trapped living that lie. You see, the thing is, to get truth, you have a direct experience. I would not tell Fiona about that kale plant. I told Ken, I saw this life form, and I've had this experience, and I explained all the sensations of that experience, and I can tell you can go there, or go and see that horse. She can go and have a direct experience. She can experience the truth of that plant without having to represent me. So the same with God. I don't have to tell her about God, and she has to represent God. She's now got a third party. Well, that's what the system is all about. It's all about third parties, intermeddlers, interlopers, interceders, getting in the way. This is what the law is all about. You're caught. C-A-U-G-H-T, you're not going to court. You're caught. You're living the lie. You're going there representing the name. You think that is who you are. You're representing that third party that you now call the driver's license or the birth certificate. But you can't talk to the driver's license. Hi, Jack. How are you, mate? Hi, Jack, where are you? Are you not Jack? Hello, birth certificate. Hello, Jack. There's nobody there. We're representing the driver's license is Alice. It's the shadow. It's I. It's the reflection in the mirror that you're looking at. You know, the greatest lie of all is I, as in all-seeing I. This line with a dot on it. I, E-Y-E, I, mind. Belief in the middle of the word belief is the word lie. I, it's the greatest lie of all. It's the shadow. It's not true. And we're brainwashed to represent that dead corpse. And everyone else is trapped representing lawyer, solicitor, journalist, media companies, law firms, political parties, liberals, labour, independent, green, alternative, and the philosophies that are espoused by that stuff. A Christian and Jew and political Jews, patriots, Judaism, Mohammedism, you know, stuff that comes out of the Bhagavad Gita's, anything of ancient Greece, any Hermetic thoughts, anything, it doesn't matter where it's come from. You have to represent those images, guys. You've fallen into nonsense. It's not real. And you're trying to dump it on your children. And you're dumping it on everyone else around you. And here's the problem that I was talking about, paperwork and filing. While you think you can go and apply your paperwork to any area in the system, you need a force to back it. If you want to put in place something to covet a piece of land or a building, right? Like what we tried to do. What do you call it? I've forgotten.
A lien.
A lien. Something to hold. Claiming that we have some right over that piece of building, right? You need a force to enforce it. And as everybody in the Free Man Movement, the Freedom Truth Movement realizes, they don't have a force behind them to back it. They're already up against force. So when you're applying paperwork, in no matter what area, who are you asking to cure something that you see that needs a remedy? To make right what's been made wrong.
And even if you did get a judge or someone to stamp your bit of paper and say, yes, okay, who's gonna come with you? Do you think the local sheriffs are going to say, oh, yes, all right, we'll come and enforce that order for you?
Let's take the Supreme Court. We put a lien on the Supreme Court because they haven't paid all the fees and charges we put them there for the time they use the name, wasting their argument with us because of some parking fine or speeding fine. You can learn about all this sort of stuff. But you still need a force to enforce that lien. You're still enforced to go to the bank and take the fictional dollars out of the zero zeros of a computer screen, transfer it to your computer screen where you've got zeros and ones on yours.
According to the paperwork we wrote when we were dealing with the State Debt Recovery Office, the sheriff's office in Wollongong owes me about $1 million. But who's going to help me come and get that $1 million?
Or go and take the building that they operate in, the courthouse, and we'll just go and take that building and sell it so we can get that $1 million.
My paperwork says they owe me that money. But
well, who's the force behind it?
So shall I send the paper down?
What power's that paper got? We haven't got force behind it. You see, we are the only ones to set paper into motion. So it needs force. The motion is force. So who's going to set force into motion to take claim ownership over anything we claim that we own? You see, while we continue on this path, we're not a remedy. And we haven't got a remedy. We're still of the system. Whilst people still live for the system, you need to have slaves and rulers, because you cannot have a man-made system without slaves and rulers. You've got to have slaves and rulers to have a man-made system. It doesn't matter whether you call it common law or something that's of democracy or constitution, or whether it is admiralty, or whether it is of whatever, even of a new monetary system, even if it's a cashless monetary system. You need to have slaves and rulers. You have to have men and women brainwashed into the intellectual property that makes up the ideas of money, of that cashless money. They have to become the administrators and the representatives and the authorities of that money. They have to become the clerks and the dealing of the paperwork of that money. This is madness, guys. This is nonsense. This is not a remedy. This is the continuation of ownership. The problem of I, mine, is ownership. That's the greatest lie of all. It's mine. My UCC. My common law, my Jesus, my astrology. You don't own it, guys. You're under a spell when you do that. That's not a remedy. The remedy is simple. Set into motion the freedom, truth, peace, joy, abundance, and do no harm for all of life in the lives of everything and everyone around you so that you can have it. Set into motion no loss of uniqueness or originality in the lives of everyone and everything around you so that you can have it. Set into motion no slaves and rulers are all around so you don't become a slave and ruler as well. If you create freedom, truth and peace and joy, etc. in the lives of everyone else around you, you've got it. So you got to live for them. You got to live for your tribe. You got to live for your community. You got to give them everything. We all live for each other's freedom. We live for each other's truth. We live for each other's peace and joy and abundance and do no harm. And we live for each other's originality of original thought and original uniqueness, which is original thought. And we live for each other's no slavery and no rulers. If you've got that all around you, then you live in paradise, guys. If everyone else has got freedom in their lives around you, you've got freedom. But if everyone else is lost in the system and you want my bit of freedom, you're never going to have it.
Because that's why no one's finding peace and freedom, because they're all looking for my peace, my inner peace, my joy, my freedom. But how can you have that when next door someone's belting someone every night? Have they got joy and freedom? So you're not free because part of you is nervous that might spill across into your life and someone might come in your door and steal your stuff. And that's not peace. That's not freedom. You cannot have it until those people around you are living in peace and freedom too.
Exactly.
Then you can breathe easy because you know that the peace and freedom's all around. You don't have to worry about locking a door. You don't have to worry about somebody coming in and doing you harm or stealing something from you.
Or forcing some bill or statute over you, worrying about paying bills or paying mortgage. Imagine having to wake up and being free to contemplate the dream of life. Then we can start unraveling all the rest of the problems of our fallen state. But, you know, yesterday I got a phone call from a journalist from Channel 7. I get a lot of phone calls from journalists, guys. I get a lot of phone calls from people inside the law. I get phone calls. I can't tell you all the names of these people. I won't tell you who this woman was. But, you know, but the thing is, she told me she really likes the good bits of the life that she has. I said, yeah, but are you going to take responsibility for all the harm that you're causing right now? For all this, for everything you have of the system? There's a cost to pay, a massive cost to pay, because you've given up responsibility. Now, she hasn't been educated about this. She wasn't given full disclosure as a child of all these images she was going to set into motion that became the background of her, whether it's private school education or not, public school education or not, whatever it is, and whatever university training course she was given or not. Whether she went to TAFE and did something at TAFE to become a journalist. She doesn't see the bigger picture, that it requires the system, the dead corpse beast that you all have to represent and carry around, requires slaves and rulers.
Well, for example, nearby, not too far away at the moment, there's a big hoo-ha going on because one of the big Korean companies want to do, what's it called? Coal spring?
Fracking.
Yeah, fracking and... which is horrendous. I agree, it's horrible, it's horrendous. But everyone's up in arms. No, 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 we can't have this here. This is a beautiful area. It's, you know, it can't be destroyed by all this. But all the people who are protesting and driving around with bumper stickers on their cars saying, no, no, we don't want them here, they're all using the gas that is the whole reason why all these forms of mining exist.
But not
because
only that.
We use the gas. So how can we protest when we're using that?
Well, let's go take it further.
It's like, how can we protest against cows being killed and yet we still eat the meat?
Exactly. But it goes worse than this. They're all believing in the system. They're passing. The reason why they do letter droplets everywhere is because they're relying on the system and some authorities in the system to stop it. Right? They're relying on all the third parties, all these prosthetics and all these people who are dumbed down and stupid. They're relying on people who represent nonsense to solve issues of sense because they sense the wrong of doing harm, which Fiona's pointing out. You know, killing a cow to get access to the meat when people don't want to kill animals anymore. And we'll talk about this as well, because this all goes back to the breath of life. Why we're not supposed to harm animals. And no animal ever gave its permission to be killed and eaten. You know, we say to tribal people, if you so believe in your customs and faith, then why is it animals still run away from you? Why don't they just come and lay down before you and just give their life to you and you can just eat them right there and then? Why do you have to hunt them? Why the boomerangs and arrows and spears and traps and everything else you do? Why do you have to do all that? If you really believe that you have some inheritance, some natural rights over this creature, when they're an equal to you, an equal team player to the dream of life. The thing is, we're not meant to be harming animals. We're not meant to be harming Earth. We're not meant to be puncturing holes in the Earth. We're not meant to be doing anything to do harm in any possible way. Because that's nonsense. It's all part of the nonsense, guys. So anyway, going back to this thing about the system, you cannot have a man-made system without having slaves and rulers. You cannot have a man-made system without brainwashing men and women into the intellectual property that they now have to represent as the characters of Alice and the Mad Hatters in the Tea Party of Wonderland. You can't do it. So while you're running around thinking that you're going to have some kind of new remedy, some new system, you know you're on the wrong track. The truth is, we have no system because it's already taken care of. Do you have to jump 10 foot across the room to grab your next breath? Of course not. You've already got it. It's already present with the presence of life. And all of nature is already provided in present sense. We've already got it all. We have to stop using nonsense to destroying everything that gives us access to everything in present sense. We have stopped living the lie of the land titles office, where we think that we're stuck as a tenant or not, in a rental property or not, where we don't have access to the food forest because we're now trespassing over someone else's land that they claim as a food forest and it's theirs, or trespassing over Commonwealth land or Crown land. This is all nonsense, guys. There's no power in any behind it. All you've got is force. The only way to solve this dilemma is to remove our life, remove our thoughts, remove the force of our life from the images we're setting to motion that is the system. And collectively, together, we reform tribes of kingdom and we take responsibility over the land that we stand on. And anyone who comes is welcome as a team player. And we caretake for them as custodians. We provide everything we've got and we share everything. All the best bits of the land that we're on are shared as community land. We don't claim it. We don't put ourselves on a higher ground or a better ground than anybody else. We take over pasteurized land that was destroyed, farming lands that have been decimated, forests that have been ruined. We go back in and restore them all, and we turn that back into kingdoms where each one has a hectare of land to take care of. And we learn to build each other's houses together. And we learn to re-educate our children away from the system. We unscrabble their brains. And we provide community schools where we don't teach them anything anymore, where they together help each other and we ask them questions and go out and let them go out there and explore and find the answers to these things. All the way from the creation of the child. There's no preschool. You know, all ages, kids together can do it for each other because they learn to be a team. They're not segregated and discriminated through age and look and height and physical appearance, etc., and colour and skin and creed, etc. No, we get rid of all this nonsense. But we have to withdraw. And that's what this is all about. We have to withdraw. We work together. Read the Steps of Kingdom. We wrote it. You'll find it. I'll put the link up again. The Steps of Kingdom, K-I-N-D-O-M. It clearly shows your way out. If there was another remedy greater than this, we'll go with that. Until a better one comes along, we always go where truth takes us. We never go with the belief, faith or opinion. We scrutinize all images, all information, no matter what, and rout out all forms of nonsense and only take the truth with us, which is what's helped us to reform the missing pieces of the puzzle that make sense of our life. That's what we've done. The Steps of Kingdom is making sense out of nonsense. You see, the greatest lie of all is I, mind. In telling Fiona about the kale, and she claims it as her belief, as her lie, as her I. It's now I, mine. That intellectual property is the role of film, now bouncing to and fro under the spell in her head, in her brain, in her senses. Now I must explain, the brain is not what's between the ears. It's the senses from the tip of the follicles, all of our hair, the ends of our hair, all those senses right down to the tips of our toes. There is no outside to water, inside to water. We are all water. There's nowhere where water isn't. There's no, you can't escape it. Everything is sense. There's no I or mind. When Fiona falls under the spell, as we've all fallen under the spell of intellectual property, and she says, I've got a mind made up of all this intellectual property that of I, because she not only believes in kale, but she'll believe everyone told her about daffodil, and about time, and about good morning, and morn, the morn, morning, as in good morning, and hello, as in hell, hell, and low, hello, and all the, you know, all this stuff, and we learnt to represent ABC and 1, 2, 3 that makes up the languages of our talk and the interest that takes up our waking life, that are the courses and careers and the survival modes where we have to keep a roof over our head and put food on the table and get our kids through school and etc., etc., right? All these things is the role of film of nonsense that you've loaded up into your life and that you are now projecting into the cinema of life as darkness. You're projecting darkness. You put the curtains and the blinds on your brain, you've shut down everything. You're now in a room where all the windows are closed in darkness. There's no access to light anywhere in this room. Every window you're looking through is darkness because there's a curtain there and a blind, which is I and mine. It's the state of belief that the child is representing as Alice. While the child is lost as Alice, the living child ain't there. She's not present with the presence of life. Well, she's not sensing it. She's too busy representing nonsense. Same as the woman ramming yesterday from Channel 7. She's too busy representing nonsense, as in the judge and the lawyers and everybody else trapped in nonsense. So while we're doing that, it's mind. It's I, mind, I. That's what it's all about. All seeing I. All you see is mine. All Fiona sees is the kale that I told her. All she sees is Christ and Jesus and the Bible. All she sees is my truth.
And this is how we get into being individuals.
Individuals.
Mine is different to yours and all that sort of stuff. And this is my land and that's your land, rather than this is all of our land.
I hope you're comprehending this, guys. I hope you're getting it. I hope the penny is dropping, because it needs to drop quick and fast. Because out of mind has come in the fall. Unless we have I to represent, there is no system. Because the system needs I, which is the belief in ownership. And it starts with who you are, your name. The sound of your name can be turned into I. The sound that comes out of your mouth that you set free is who you are. That's the sound of the parents gave you your name. That's who you are. That sound can be uttered by every other man to call your name. But the moment you claim it as yours and you use it as intellectual property over a piece of land or over any form of intellectual property, no matter what, it's now mine. I. Now you need a system to enforce and protect that I and mine. That's what the obelisk is all about, guys. I, mind, it's mine. One, sameness. That's what it is. It's not a truth, it's a lie. So when you're thinking about any kind of remedies, watch out for all the storytellers coming at you left, right, and center every possible way, because they're going to fill the eye up with mind. And that mind, you'll think, is the escape route out of Wonderland, when it's not at all. You have just been prepared to fall into the next version of the system. You've been trapped.
And the easy way to spot it is to think, well, am I taking responsibility for my life under this remedy?
Am I giving up my uniqueness and my originality? Am I giving up the uniqueness and originality of every man, woman and child to fall into the next version of the system? What are they offering? Simple. Ask them the question. What is the remedy you have that provides freedom, truth, peace, joy, abundance, and do no harm for all of life without causing loss of uniqueness or originality to anyone and anything, and without the need for slaves and rulers? Ask them to bring forward the evidence. You find they haven't got one, guys. They don't have it. Because they can't. Because they'll be killed off. They'll be destroyed and obliterated under their oaths of destruction to their families. Devastation to their bank accounts. Watch out for all the sacrificing, ritual sacrificing these people, what they're doing right now to Julian the son, right? Being butchered. They're doing it intentionally to set him up as a good guy. But he's one of them. Look carefully. Look at the post we put up about him. I'll provide you the links at the end of this video. Watch out for all the whitewashing and white-anting tactics. They're coming at you in 1,001 ways. They're very clever. What you've got to do is look for I. And piss it off. Get rid of it. Stop being caught in the reflection. Stop being trapped in the mirror of your projection. You are man. We are all man. And in direct experience, in present sense, we don't need I or mind. You see, you do not have to represent truth, because the moment you try to represent truth, it's now a lie. Everyone has direct access to truth. Everyone has direct experience of freedom. Everyone has direct access to air and water, which is water. We've already got it all, guys. We've got to stop falling into nonsense so that we don't have to fall further into a system to protect that nonsense of I and mind. Is the penny dropping? Are you waking up? Because that's what it's going to take, guys. We need to come together now and just take over suburbs. Wake up everyone around us and just say, piss off the system. Piss off the councils. Goodbye to the law. Goodbye to Barry. You don't need them anymore. As long as each of you take full responsibility for everything you think, feel and do. And see that all men are equal. That no man is master of another man. And you do not do harm to any original life form. And that you are committed to restore everything back to original.
And the real key is working together. Because if we're each on our own, try to set up our food for us, try to set up our everything we need, it's really hard work. If we do it together, if we pull what we have and what we know, things happen very fast.
My money, my freedom, my truth. You've got to get past all this. You don't own anything, guys. It's a lie. There is no money. There is no freedom in that way. There is no truth in that way. Nonsense is not freedom. It's not truth. It's not money. Where can our children go to money, to learn about money, without us having to brainwash them first? Or go to anyone who's being brainwashed for them to learn about it? Where can they learn about I and mind without us having to put those images in their head and for them to learn about it? Nowhere. It doesn't need it. So watch out for all these false prophets. They're coming at you every possible way. The great man of long ago revealed all this to all of you. And we brought the system down at those times, as we've done every other system that existed. We kept bringing them down, as we're doing it again now. Many of us are coming forward to do the same thing. Yes, it's the same thing. Representing the lie and exposing it for what it is and walking away from it as a mass exodus, a peaceful, non-violent, do no harm withdrawal from setting into motion the system, because we are the force. While you live for the system and you want the good bits of the system, you set the system into motion. Your force, that is your life, is the power that sets the dead corpse of the system into motion, that has you walk and talk and think and feel and poo and wee and negotiate and contract for it. If you want true freedom, you have to walk away from system science in all its forms. You have to walk away from engineering. You have to walk away from all forms of construction of dead things. You have to walk away from the read and write alphabet languages. We have to walk away from everything that's occult and esoteric based. Everything, guys. We have to walk away from race, culture, creed. Now, we have to do it smart. We have to be conscious of what we're walking away off, so we don't represent and create new ones, so we keep falling for the same trap. We can't expect this to happen overnight, one big instant flick. It's going to be a gradual change, as fast as we possibly can. And the steps of kingdom show this. And we can adapt it. If we can get enough of us together, we can create this mudroom that we explained in it. The mudroom is where we bring all the shit there, and there it stays. All the crap of all our nonsense. And when we leave the mudroom, we don't bring it with us anymore, because we return to kingdom, we return to man. We explain this in the Steps of Kingdom document. We need to get these kingdoms off the ground as soon as possible now. We're ready for it. Come together with us. We're not your leader. All great leaders have no followers. No one follows us. We're an inspiration. A lot of people write to say we're inspiration. We take responsibility for that inspiration. Why we do this on video. Why we continue persisting in doing this work we do. We just do not give up. Because there's nowhere else for us to go to. We have nothing else to live for. We don't want the dead world. We see for what it is in all its forms. We suffer for it. We suffered immensely for it. Our bodies, particularly this body of this man, has suffered immensely for this. We sacrifice immensely for this. Not for mind. We don't want glory. I just want the freedom of man all around me so that I can have it. I want the peace and the truth in the lives of man all around so I can have it too. I want the paradise of kingdom all around me, so I live in paradise. That's what I live for. I sensed that as a child, but I didn't have anywhere to go to. We all sense things are wrong. We're just showing you how to dot the I's and cross the T's now. We're showing you the deception and how to get out of it now. Do you want to take responsibility for do no harm? If you do, then we come together and form kingdoms quickly. If you don't, you'll continue going to work. You'll continue worrying about your mortgage. You'll continue worrying about your bills. You'll continue worrying to keep all the good bits of the system, whether it's your belief in science and all the good things you think of science, whether it's the good things of Christianity and the good things of Judaism and the good things of whatever it is that you're holding on to that is of the system. Because you'll keep using your force to set that force into motion, and you'll need that force to protect that claim you have, because you want the best ground, you want the best bits, you want all the good things that are television and technology, and you want all the good bits of motor cars, and you want all the other good things. It's all harm and destruction.
McDonald's and fairy floss and
exactly, and everything else is coming from all the slaves and everybody else out there has to do all this work for you so you can have your cappuccino in your coffee shop. That's what it's all about, guys. If you want to live a do no harm way of life, then you've got to recognize harm in all its forms and withdraw from setting that into motion with your force, with your life, with your breath. That's what this is all about. We've got to stop having the system. So unless you can recognize I and mind in the constructs that you represent and see for what it is, you'll be unable to withdraw from that, because you'll still be under the spell of that hood that rules you, that keeps you driven, is my philosophy, my scientific microscope, my telescope, my information that's coming out of science, my astrology, my numerology, my Bible, my prophecies, etc., my Moses, because it's mine now. You've claimed it as I. Lie. Believe. Be the lie. Belief. That's what's happening here.
So the only way is to go back to the water. Well, everything's created out of water.
Every time we breathe out, we create water. Going back to the beginning of the video here. And we're using lineal terms here to explain it again. Because there is nothing lineal about this, because there's no outside inside to the hologram that is the bubble. But just imagine the Creator created the dream of life, all the information, and to give it sense, it breathed its life, it moved its life into the bubble. And there is nowhere in the dream of life where the presence of the living Creator is present. It's present everywhere. There is nowhere where it ain't. Its presence of life is always presence. That presence of life is the sun shining here and now. It's the love of man bouncing back at us. That love for life is the sun shining back at us. If we forget to live for the dream of life, we become the ants and we live for the dead system of I and mine, of the dead colony world, the dead worlds. We're withdrawing our light, our life force energy. And we become the sun that has no light. And because we've fallen into darkness, and every man's fallen into darkness, there's no light bouncing back to us either. Because that's what the sun is. It's the light, the love of man bouncing back at us. It's not the sun as in the solar system, as in system science, astronomy, and all that. That's all nonsense, guys.
We're moving more and more of who we are out of the water, or the water out of us, so we're becoming more and more dead, hence all the sickness and disease.
Because that's what a microscope
we're
is.
Moving away from life. So what's going to happen if we move away from life? We're going to start decaying and falling apart.
That's what cancer is. That's what all sickness and disease is. We're removing life, that is the breath of life, out of water. In setting into motion the dream of life, that presence of life is man. The Creator is man. We are the Creator in our true form. And the Creator held the whole dream of life. And as the Creator kept creating the dream of life of man, the Creator then created man and created man. So now we have a co-creator of man. And the dream of life, of sense, that the breath that we're breathing out, there's nowhere where our breath isn't, is penetrating every image that sense we've given life to. We all have this gift. We can go into the microbes and give microbes purpose to send them into every nuclear reactor and every company and dissolve that thing quickly. We have this power. We can go and send microbes into the Sydney Harbour Bridge and dissolve that Sydney Harbour Bridge like that. We have this power. We have this power to change all nonsense and return it to sense quickly. We can also restore all the lowlands that were decimated by all the oceans and raise the water canopy back up. And that's why they're doing the chemtrails and the chemical trails. Is they don't want us to reform the water, because the DNA of man's thought, if you imagine again the dream of life, is made up of the matrix of DNA linking with DNA, all the threads and strands of man's thought, that is the Creator's thought, that makes up everything, interconnected with everything interconnected, that is the horse, the cow, the water, the grass, the insects, the celestial bodies, man, and everything that makes the dream of life. To set the whole thing into motion, it set its breath into it, to set the whole dream into motion. And that dream of life is present to us right now. And that is the DNA.
And that's what we need to be doing, setting our breath into life rather than into anti-life.
Not distorting the DNA, not altering it, but co-creating and expanding it. And as the Creator created man, and there's another man, and there's two men now breathing, if you want to use lineal terms here, adding more breath to the dream of life, Earth is expanding. As more and more man are being created, and more man breathing water into the dream of life, Earth is expanding, because Earth is the dream of life. Earth is not turning, it's not moving, it's not going around the sun. You know, they tell you about Mars and Venus and all that, but this is all nonsense. Have they told you, have you looked at those life forms, let them tell you what they're doing? Like I told you about Fi with the kale, or a daffodil or something. There is no solar system. Have you seen anybody with their own eyes see the solar system the way it's described in pictures and drawings? Of course not. You haven't. No one has. Has anyone been to the Dark Ages? Has anyone been to any of the ages? No one. Can they bring forward anyone who's been there? You can't, because it's nonsense. There was no presence of life present. But when we go to the cow, when we go to the horse, we can connect with the presence of life of every cow that ever was and ever will be. Because they take responsibility for that presence in present sense. So we don't have to represent the cow. We don't have to act as the cow. We don't have to act as Alice the cow, acting as if what I'm thinking about the cow is what the cow's saying. This is the problem of system science, everything else. People are making all these claims, saying it's true. So when you ask them, bring forward the first party to back your claim, they can't. They can't bring forward anything. Hence the police officer who says that you're doing 80 Ks in a 40 K zone. He can't bring forward the statute that he's claiming to be true, to claim that you've done some harm, that you've broken the peace, you've caused a crime, you know, that you've done something that is a jail sentence or that needs punishment. He's just believing the lie that is makes him the police officer enforcing the statutes of law of the system. And if you believe it, you'll fight for that claim and you'll become possessed. Possess Sion, Zion, possession. You are now the name, believing in that claim, and you go to court, C-A-U-G-H-T, where you exhaust your energy as the name, the representative of that name. Now, it's the same as everybody who believes in the lie of I of whatever intellectual property you're claiming to be true. No matter what, it doesn't matter. You can go everywhere. This is, you'll find trails of this in all our arguments, debates, all documented in the Love for Life website. It's all up there. Hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of scrutiny with NASA astrophysicists, for example, and scientists and all kinds of people, and theologians and experts and all. They can't bring forward the first parties that they claim to be true. They can't bring forward the solar system. They can't bring forward Mars or Venus. They're just Alice representing Mars and the solar system and the galaxies and the universe that David Icke peddles and everyone else is peddling the universe. What universe? Bring forward oneness. Where's oneness? You see, unless we can use our brain to scrutinize all forms of nonsense, we'll keep bringing nonsense with us, like a monkey on our back. We'll keep bringing the darkness. We'll keep bringing the system of harm that we keep setting into motion to continue destroying all the good intentions of what we're living for. We'll bring harm into what we think we're going to call paradise. This is why we're setting up these workshops. We're asking, you can come now. You can have up to 20 people. We'll put up dates. If you want to come here, we can set up groups. If you want to provide gifts, you're welcome. We do it for free. If you like to support what we're doing, we'll put on one-day workshops, or even weekend workshops, here at the house, here. Come right here. Come work in the garden for weekends. 20 of you. Come together on a bus. Come in. We'll help you. We'll teach you everything we know. But we don't want you to be in our image. We're not following us. But we'll help each other co-create together the living dream. Will help you to scrutinize all forms of nonsense so you can use sense to get out, because you need sense to go back to sense. You don't want to bring nonsense back to sense because you keep doing harm. So don't fall for the remedy they're going to offer you, and no matter what form it comes, because it will be a lie buried in it of many lies. And as I explained before in other videos, it only takes one lie hidden in a mountain of truths to destroy all truth. One tiny bit of black or gray dropped in pure white destroys all of pure white. It's no longer pure and sincere. It's no longer sense. One tiny hull holding back, in a wall holding back a massive ocean of lies, one massive wall holding back a massive ocean of lies, will still destroy everything it's trying to protect. That community immunity of that one tiny lie where there's a crack will seep through and wear away in that hull. And the man and woman who are using that lie, thinking it's true, because in the Bible there is lies in there. But because they're giving you morally correct truths, you're thinking everything of the Bible is true. And because they're using their force to set into motion morally correct truths, they're also setting into motion the images that are the lies. And it is those lies that are doing all the damage. And that's what the Freemasons do. They hide the lies, as in time codes. And the thought of God is not God. They give you this thing of God, separate from you, where you don't have responsibility because you're going to pass the buck, because you're on a journey heading from somewhere to somewhere to some Jesus who's going to come to save you in the afterlife. And while you're on the journey heading towards your getting a roof over your head and paying your mortgage and surviving your debts and credits and getting your kids through school, you're on a journey through the system, because that's a spell that's been spun on you based on all the system science that they spun you on the bigger picture. And because you feel powerless because you're a tiny aspect of this system wonderland, and you're at the effect of it. of the astrology and numerology and all the other things that people are putting in your head, all these images putting in your head, that you want to take responsibility for. So bring it down into present sense. If you can't rout out all this nonsense, you're going to keep bringing the lie. So that tiny hole with all that stuff seeping will wear the hole, and more lies will start coming in into the man. That wall is man, right? Living the lie. He calls himself a Christian, or she calls himself a Jew, or a Buddhist, whatever. They're all lies, guys. And the more they live that lie, the lie gets worn away, and then more lies are coming in. And through the gradualism passed down through the generations, the crack is opening up wider and wider and wider. And more of the lies are coming into our thoughts. These are images we're thinking. Until the force of the lie is so strong, because so many of men no longer of the communion meaning, they no longer live the truth anymore, because they are now the crack in the hull. They are part of the problem that is the lie of I and mind and intellectual property set into motion, etc. That the whole wall is the ant colony where all the ants fled to live the individual state, e-state, ecclesiastical state, right? And the wall comes down. And now we're flooded completely in lies. And when that happens, the whole dream of life is gone because it's all darkness. There's no light anymore, no life.
Living for the love that lights up in our hearts. We're living for the dream of a world of do no harm. We're living for our kin, our tribe of conscious men. We're living for the truth, no more waiting for saviors.